Men's room stall. Penis! Two penises!
I love Community. Like, seriously, I love this show. It's so good that it makes me want to actually go to a real community college. But, apparently they're a little bit different in real life. Anyway, there are countless reasons why this show is so good. Like, the great dialogue, funny story. But I think the best thing about it is the characters. So if you give me just a little bit of time, I'll explain why the characters on Community are just so good. So, one of the big problems that I have with television as a whole is that a lot of the characters across shows, and sometimes even on the same show, feel kinda samey. Like how all of the main doctors on basically every medical show have the same personalities, and the main characters on every action slash thriller show all basically behave the same way and all have more or less the same characteristics. They've become one of the worst things you can be on television. Predictable. But that's where Community shines, because its characters act like almost a satire on these predictable tropes. In order for me to fully explain this, let's take a closer look at Jeff's character. Jeff is a cool, fast-talking, slightly selfish, good-looking lawyer who can convince basically anyone of basically anything. He's your classic cool guy slash lawyer trope from basically every lawyer TV show you've ever seen, and there's kind of a lot of them. But he subverts your expectation of these tropes by being kicked out of his firm for faking his credentials and then going from acclaimed lawyer to community college student. This subversion of the classic trope is what makes his character so good. You expect one thing, then the show gives you another. This satire of classic characters is nothing short of genius. Let's look at another example, one Mrs. Annie Edison. Annie is probably the best example of my point. When we first meet her, she seems like the classic hardworking schoolgirl character we've seen hundreds of times. Examples include Lisa Simpson from The Simpsons, Leslie Knope from Parks and Rec, Felicity Smoke from Arrow, and Amy Santiago from Brooklyn Nine-Nine. I'm not saying that there aren't new or interesting ways to do a character like this. I'm just showing how this has become somewhat predictable. But then, the show totally subverts this trope by giving her a form of pill addiction and giving her moments where she's just straight up crazy. It's this unpredictable and subversion of traditional character tropes that make this character so genius. Now, there are a lot of other examples on this show, so I'm just going to go through them one by one kinda quick. Shirley is the traditional religious mother figure, but they subvert that trope by giving her underlying anger issues and by having her divorce her husband, which is something I've been told Jesus does not approve of. Troy is this dumb jock who only cares about himself, but they change it up by giving him a love of pop culture and showing how he's not actually the jock we all thought he was at first through his friendship with Abed. Pierce is the wise old mentor who turns out to be completely racist and in many ways more childlike than even Troy and Abed. Britta is the hot, cool hippie chick who likes fighting the man, but they subvert that trope by making her a huge buzzkill and having everyone kinda dislike her. Chang is their teacher, but he changes your perception of what a teacher is on television by being both completely insane and constantly bullying his students. And the dean subverts the traditional authority figure by being a closeted homosexual, in love with Jeff, and is just as crazy as the rest of them. And Abed is, well...
The show's gonna last 3 weeks!
6 seasons and a movie!
So, why does it matter? What is it about the subversion of tropes that makes this show so good? It works because when you have a satire of traditional television baked right into your characters, it automatically adds another level of humor to anything you do with them. When you take that and then apply it as well as it has been done in a Community, this decision becomes nothing short of genius. Hey guys, so this is my first ever video on YouTube. I hope you liked it. I'm going to be looking to put out videos about every 2 weeks, which is about how long it took me to make this one. If you like the video, please subscribe. And if you like the video but don't want to subscribe, that's okay too. Live your life how you want. I'm not your mom, but if I were your mom, I would tell you to subscribe. And then, I don't know, go clean your room. On that weird note, bye.